Hi, it's me, Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut. Check out this photograph. Whoa. No, you're not seeing SpaceX's attempt to create a wormhole to another universe. This image was captured by my friend and fellow launch photographer, Trevor Malman, at SpaceX's most recent Falcon 9 rocket launch that just took place at 1:50 a.m. local Eastern Time on July 22, 2018. The mission was to deliver the Telstar 19 Vantage communication satellite to a geostationary transfer orbit, which it did successfully. At 1 minute into flight, right around when the SpaceX announcer says the vehicle's supersonic, we see this.
Because it means that from that moment on, we're going through thinner and thinner atmosphere and less stress.
Okay, so what is this? Well, if you're anything like me, you may have thought that was the vapor cone that we might see when a vehicle goes supersonic, like this, or like this one, or this. How about this one? I love those, but no, it's not that. Those vapor cones stay connected to the vehicle. They move with it. This is different. Right after this phenomenon, we hear the call out stating the vehicle has reached maximum aerodynamic pressure. This is also known as max Q, and it's when the rocket hits the peak of its aerodynamic stress. So, in other words, the rocket is going faster and faster and faster, which increases the pressure on the vehicle. But a rocket is also getting higher and higher, so the atmosphere is thinner and thinner. So there's a point where those two things intersect, where the vehicle is going fast, really fast, but after a certain point, despite going faster, the atmosphere gets so thin and eventually almost non-existent, which then, of course, decreases the pressure on the rocket. But it's also not that at all. It's not max Q either. So, okay. What is this? Well, what you're actually seeing is the rocket interacting with the different layers of humidity and temperature in the atmosphere. These condensation trails are caused by the temperature of the rocket exhaust creating water vapor, which then quickly freeze in the higher altitude environment, forming what are essentially frozen cloudish things. We actually see this all the time as rockets pass through different layers of the atmosphere, and right when the conditions are just right, ta-da, condensation trails. Rockets also leave a wake of low pressure, which is where you see these rings of condensation happening. That's so incredibly cool. And then, of course, we're basically seeing the light from the rocket get scattered through the water and ice molecules and pretty much form rainbows. Dang, a rocket that farts rainbows. What will Elon think of next? Jeez. Well, actually, one of SpaceX's upcoming rockets will truly utilize what is essentially just farts. Their big Falcon rocket will use liquid methane and liquid oxygen in the Raptor engines that power it. So then, surely we'll see rockets farting rainbows, I guess. Oh, and one last thing, condensation trails like this happen all the time. We just don't always get the right conditions to see it scatter like a rainbow. But in the right circumstances, even airliners can produce this phenomenon, and it's amazing. Ugh, I love that. If you need a rundown on what this launch was, what it did, where it went, why, when, what, why, how, I live streamed along with it and explained all the exciting things that went along with this mission. So you can also see my reaction when I saw those amazing condensation trails start. Check it out in this video here. You can join me for upcoming missions. I start streaming around T-minus 30 minutes or so. Be sure you're following me on Twitter so you get notifications when I'll be covering launches. Also subscribe here on YouTube. And hopefully I'll see you at the next one where I can answer your questions and you can join the conversation live. But even more important than that, keep up with Trevor Malman's amazing work on Twitter at Trevor Malman or Instagram at tmalman and help support him at patreon.com/Trevor Malman. And while you're at it on Patreon, stop on over to my page if you'd like to help support me to continue producing content like this, launch live streams, longer form scripted videos, and news articles on my website, everydayastronaut.com. You can also hang out in our exclusive Discord channel and subreddit by becoming a Patreon. So head on over to patreon.com/everydayastronaut. Thanks, everybody. That's going to do it for me. I'm Tim Dodd, the Everyday Astronaut, bringing space down to Earth for everyday people.